Tradition is not the worship of ashes, but the preservation of fire. Tradition means taking account of the wonderful history, but also at the same time looking towards the future. My name is Maria Nepembe, the face of the Olufuko Cultural Festival. Welcome to Otapi. In front of the Olufuko traditional homestead, which is currently being prepared for the festivities that will be taking place between the 24th of August and the 4th of September. Now, I did manage to sit down and talk to the individuals who have made this festival possible. Take a look.
Thank you very much. My name is Nashilongo Ananias. I'm the CEO of Otapi Town Council. The return of the Olufuko cultural, it has changed in the youth, the way they have behave. The town of Otapi is benefited very well. I could remember that since the initiation, the establishment of the Olufuko, we were only having one hotel. That is Otapi, but as we are talking now, we are having 11 accommodation. We being a guest house and a lodge, including those are the one that now we are having in the town. Yeah, even now tourism, they were also just pass here. Otapi was just a gateway.
Yeah.
And now it's becoming a destination. The girls that what they get from Olufuko, as I said, is. It's the benefit of respecting the elders. That's the one of the benefits, the main benefit that they get there. Secondly, is to know their own culture and how they have to respect it and maintain it. Now they know how they have to behave, and that is a benefit that they have been receiving from the Olufuko.
My name is Geraldes, surname is Gavin Dunga. I'm the branch manager for Standard Bank Otapi. Standard Bank is an organization with our mission being Namibia is our home. The concept of Olufuko, with all the economic activities attached to it, we believe it's an opportunity for us as an organization to get involved and enhance the business community, the SME involved in the whole activity taking place. So we felt as an organization is a platform that we can give a helping hand and contribute towards the economic advancement of the town. Olufuko Festival within itself, except for the economic part that is there, there is the cultural part, which we believe that as an organization, culture plays a role, a bigger role in the development of the society. If the individual involved or the people who are doing business and from a cultural background that is stable and will not be able to achieve the goal that we want to achieve as a country. And the value that Olufuko Festival wants to install in the younger girls, we believe that it's an opportunity that we can play a role as an organization to be able to lay the right fundamental stage where life can begin and move forward. So we believe that with the correct foundation being laid from home, so wherever they go, they're going to contribute to the economic development, the society growth, and the well-being of the whole country. So we believe that, we hope that with the involvement of the bank, We're going to help them become a better place.
That was a word from our sponsors. But what exactly is the general public's take on the Olufuko Cultural Festival? I sat down with Poya Media CEO Ilka Platt, and here is what she had to say.
Hi, my name is Ilka Platt. I'm the founder of Poya Media, a PR and communications agency. I think it's wonderful. It's an initiative that many other corporates should also follow suit. I think especially for the youth, it's important to remember where you came from, traditional values, traditional cultures. When we see GBV and, you know, youth engaging in alcohol and so many of the illnesses of society, it reminds us to go back to the drawing board. When I did some research, you know, through the Olufuko Festival, it was interesting to see that it's about the basics. It's about manners. It's about morals. It's about values. It's about respecting each other, getting ready for marriage. And through this initiative, again, it reminds us on where we should be going, how we should be behaving, and with the endorsement, you know, with the founding father, this is something that we need to be reminded. The first time I went to Otapi was over 5 years ago, and it's amazing to see how fast you know, towns are developing, and Otapi is one of them. We have so many business avenues, we have so many malls, we have so many pubs, yes, we have so many hair salons, and that's entrepreneurship. You know, entrepreneurship doesn't have to be a big fancy building. Entrepreneurship could be, you know, a shop where you sell hair, where you sell makeup or whatever it may be. There's a lot of potential. That's the number one key thing. And that side, I would love to venture into Otapi and go that side. And who knows, maybe Poya Media can also venture into the town of Otapi. Cheers!
The Olufuko audience can look forward to some great entertainment from some of the most talented Namibian musicians. I took it upon myself to talk to two of them just to find out what we can expect from their performances during the festival.
My name is Monica Pinias, known as Top Cherry. I'm an actress, I'm a musician, and I'm an author.
My name is Tulinanda Fialako, known as Young T. I'm an actor, I'm a musician, I'm a producer, everything.
A lot of people have the wrong idea about the festival. They think it's this thing about virgins and only virgins. Don't get involved, you're not a virgin. Well, I would really like the platform to tell people that it's a cultural event that showcases how diverse the Oshiwambo people are, how our ancestors used to do things, which is really, really interesting. If we live life now the way that they used to live it, I believe everything will be so much smoother.
Olufuko originally was like, you know, about now, you know, girls getting grown, being prepared to go help their husbands. But I like what they did with the festival. They didn't only keep it to that. They like made sure they made it a platform where people get to meet this food that we no longer have around this, you know, this kind of things. And I really like what they do. You guys, I'm really looking forward to mingling with you. I mean, come on, it's the greatest gathering in Otapi. It's the greatest gathering, actually, gathering of the year in Namibia.
Yeah.
That's like a very, very, very big event for us. So.
The Omosati region has undoubtedly seen some progressive change ever since the Olufuko Cultural Festival was firstly introduced 7 years ago. Who better to elaborate more on this topic but the governor of Omosati region?
Not to keep you for too long.
Yes.
And the first question is, what kind of value has the Olufuko Festival brought to the Omosati region?
The value that have brought to Omosati region is that firstly, we have identified ourselves as a region where we respect culture and we take value of our cultural heritage. As a result, we have come up with a festival that fit and depict also our cultural value that have been taking place in this area for time immemorial.
Hosting such a big festival as the Olufuko Cultural Festival, it hosts thousands of people. How do you guys prepare for that? It can't be easy.
Olufuko Festival, really, it is costly. It's a very costly exercise. Because firstly, you have to mobilize the community through the traditional authorities to get the brands. And then secondly, you have to go also outside there to make a proper marketing for the event. And then you must bring also relevancy to what you want, to the program that you want to set up. As a result, because of that, a lot of preparation, it really invites a lot of people to come and attend the festival.
Okay, so what would you say is the best thing that the region gets out of the festival?
Well, it's very evident. If you go around the region now, currently you could see this small places that you knew, now they become big growth points, and some of them you can see already the development wherever you go. Mm-hmm. Olufuko Festival by itself also itself is a marketing tool. A festival only lasts for 24 or let me say for 5 days, but the impact, it will last for many years to come.
Years.
As a result, you know, we have currently receive a lot of investment opportunities. People are inquiring about the services that they wanted to render, and therefore, you know, we cannot overemphasize about Olufuko. We are very excited, and you know, it has been, and specifically now having the face of Olufuko, a beautiful lady.
Thank you.
My goodness, everybody wants to see, and you know, as a result, hey, you people are doing a great job. You also help a lot to attract more people to come to our region through your marketing.
The town of Otapi is one with beautiful and unforgettable scenery, friendly people, as well as a bright and prosperous future in terms of development. My name is Marianne Pembe. I'll see you on the 24th of August as we celebrate our culture and our heritage at the 2018 Olufuko Cultural Festival.